Thank you for tuning in to LA Talk Live, reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we're more than just talk. Stay tuned.
Lou Break Beat Flores, ultimate breaks and beats. The way I was raised, you only held accountable for what you know. Check it. They try to tell me the original man, he wasn't born on this indigenous land. I give them pilgrims a hand, they be resilient when they building the plan. I got the skills to reveal it's a scam, so here I am. It's more of science, and the more you apply it, the more these devils find it hard to deny. The more they won't even try it, the more they won't be stealing deeds and hide, because the Moors will be bringing the riot. Check it. They trying to tell me that Osama was guilty for 9/11. They got filthy rich and bombed him to heaven. He wasn't on, I was alone because they killed him and killed all his brethren and set him at sea so nobody can see. They said Obama's not a citizen. Shit is in disarray because they got innocent immigrants living in fear every day. They be shivering and slipping these bitter politicians, and they be getting them to work for lesser pay. They try to tell me that the earth is alone in the universe, but we're the first diverse opponent to use it to birth the component. The moment that we surface, we knew we and work it, it serves its purpose, so these devils try to hurt it. They try to tell me they're no alien beings, but I'm the only alien they be seeing. But I ain't scary and green, the melanin be having scary and fleeing, because they fear that I'll appear in their dreams. They try to tell me serve the god of my enemy, scarring and killing me. Then they tell me God is a friend of me, honestly is it me? Do I need to honor my enemies, deities who doing rituals to stop up my energy? They try to tell me that the voodoo that you do is doo-doo, but who do you call when the voodoo that you do is all you ever perform? Now they tell you that voodoo is wrong, but I bet it's strong, am I cuckoo to mention at all? They tell my children that it's Adam and Eve, then Adam and Steve, but they don't say the Adam and we, it's adamantly divine, so the Vatican be just back in the priest and lying and attacking our seeds. They try to tell me that the balance of life can be preserved without me having a wife. I'm here to challenge the hype, I speak the truth, I'm not the arrogant type. You in the dark, I'm here to carry the light. Check it. They try to tell me that nobody is living in 2012, so you gotta be kidding. Too many devils with a cosmic opinion, but who the hell knows the proper intentions of the Mayans and what they forgot to mention? They try to tell me I was born on this planet, but damn it, they sampled the granite from the spot that we landed in Kemet, and you'll understand it that they managed to damage our ability to ascend it. Now our spirit is stranded. They say the melanin will never be better or relevant than any devil who's excelling and dwelling in medicine to bring the terror in this era, but never again, cause we are the beginning and know there is never an end. They say I'm mortal, but I live through the blood, I live through the stars, I live through the mud, I live through the bars, from portal to portal, I live through the planet on Mars, and I order will show you I'm royal, immortal, I'm God. They try to tell me that my skills are diminished, I'm finished, but I give a knock of the business, you be the witness, I'm popped to the finish, and you know the top is the limit, you couldn't stop it if I popped it and spit it. They try to tell me I'm too old to flow, I'm too old to blow, but I beat done stole a show, going toe to toe. You don't wanna go see though with this old the pro. Oh no, so now you know.
Woo! Y'all don't know, that's Black Dot. That's where the hip hop I come from. That's where the hip hop I come from. Listen. That was Black Dot. If you don't know, go check my man out. He be in LA coming up real soon. It's gonna be fire. He's coming to the studio too, but he's performing in LA. He's going to be coming to the Sabir Bey Show. I'm telling you. Listen, don't nobody spit bars like that anymore. Let's be real. Don't nobody get down like that anymore. Come on. He said, y'all think I'm too old to flow? Did y'all just hear the history? He said, the Moors will be bringing the right. Come
fire.
On, man. Fire. You like that? We got Space Dweller in the building. Got my young soldier. How you like that? That's hot, ain't it, bro?
Yeah, that was dope.
That was dope. Yo, see, we bring the young soldiers in so they can know where real hip hop come from. We got D Braxton. Actually, my co-host has walked in. Tasha. Peace, Tosh. Let it get a seat. You got D Brax in the building, the rap project up in here.
No doubt, no doubt.
Yo, let me tell you, you don't know my man, go check out my man. Now I Know Black Dot. You know what I mean? The joint is fire. It was done by one of my producers on Turtle Gang. You know what I mean? Up in New York. So big up to New Yorkers in the building too. Philadelphia. We got my man, we got a host of people. And this is a pack house today. This is a pack house. We got my DJ Haze up in there, DJ Sal in the building. With Alberto, we got my cameraman Alberto. We got a house full. We got my team in here. Prince up in here. We got everybody, man. We got two legends, y'all. It's going down. We got two legends in the building. We got my man, the teacher, KRS One, is in the green room. We coming in soon. And we have my man Jerry Bell from New Birth Dad's Band back in the building again.
Yo, yo, yo.
So you can't get no better than this. Come on, man. Right. Come on. You got, yo, we got a lineup for the Sabir Bey Show, y'all. We got my man Hawthorne James Big Red from Five Heartbeats will be in next week. Tommy Davidson will be in at the end of the month. We got a whole lot of people coming up in here, yes, man. We got some other names. We just ain't naming them right now, but we got some fire. And big up to my producer over there, owner of the station, my man Rich. He liked to be in the low.
What's up? What's up, my son?
What's going
How's
on, man?
Going, man?
Yes, sir.
Man, you brought the heat today, brother.
Yo,
you got
man.
A film crew.
Yeah, we got a film crew. This is what we
know,
do. It's a
you got stars. You know, you got artists. You got DJs.
Poets.
And, listen, don't get too Hollywood on me, okay, son?
Now, I'm neighborhood.
And there you go. Stay in the hood with
you.
Know,
okay? You know, and it's funny because Paul Moon say
here,
it all the time. I got that.
Stay here, guerrilla work in this internet global broadcasting
oh,
that we're doing,
definitely.
Man, because you're definitely bringing the heat. Rousing round of applause for you, my brothers. Yeah. Once again, welcome.
And we have Space Dweller's mom in the building, Asia Jackson, sitting in the cut. She's
oh,
a, she's a never,
here.
Never poet. Never poet. You know what I mean? Karen can't be here with us today. She's she's the one that handles all the businesses with the Sabir Bey Show and everything. So, yo, we got it going down, man. It's going to be fire. So stay tuned. We'll be right back with the teacher coming up. Listen, just don't come in looking for the music. We dropping some jewels, Jack. You know what I mean? We got an event coming up, right? Tasha, you got the event right there.
Right here.
Let everybody know about that. It's gonna be fire. Y'all don't want to miss
fire.
This.
When January 12th.
Into the mic.
January 12th, okay, 3 to 6 p.m. Jose Pimenta Bay will be here, speaking to us, bringing us some vital information. Okay, so let's come and let's get knowledge.
Where's
fed.
That at? Where's it at?
This is going to be at the Victory Banquet Room, 817 North La Brea, Inglewood, California.
Is it a number on there that can reach everybody?
Yes,
I mean,
the number is, let's get this number right here. Yeah, 562-644-3194. Tickets are $20 and $25
at the door. Y'all don't want to miss this. I'm trying
don't
to tell
miss
you.
It.
Y'all don't listen.
Let's
Jose Pimenta Bay.
Fed.
He's only going to be here for one day. So
day.
You want to know the connection between the Latinos and the so-called Mexicans with the Moors? You got to come out to this event. Y'all don't want to miss it. But if y'all didn't get that whole flyer, you can always hit us up at the studio. It's 323-247-7443. That's 323-247-7443. And you know what? I'm going to get this number down pat. Cause I still got my old number back in Philly when I used to do radio. I didn't even have to look at the board at one time. I just spit it at the top of my head. So stay tuned, y'all. We got the teacher. KRS One is in the building, man. He's going to hold it down. Yo, go grab a friend. Yo, this is history, right? They say the two teachers are in the building. So we got a lot of stuff we're going to talk about, like art of deception. Come on, man. We got law books, everything in the building. So stay tuned. We'll be right back to the Sabir Bey Show.
All right.
Sabir Bey Show. Sabir Bey Show.
Talk Live and the Talk Live Broadcast Network, original reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk. Stay tuned.
Sabir Bey Show. 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 Sabir Bey Show.
Out the gate again, time to raise the stakes again. Bat my plate again. Y'all cats know we always play to win. GNG to the stars, son. Haters took this shit too far, son. So that's all for you. I'm wiping out your whole team. Ow, splatter your dreams with lyrics to shatter your schemes. The badder you seem, the more lies you tell. The more lies you sound. Now by surprise you fell into my death trap, right into my clutches. Stupid, you know the guard must bless every single mic he touches. I've suffered just so I can return harder. Wanna be this starter, fuck around, make you a martyr. I'll make you famous, turn around and make you nameless. Cause you never understood how vital to me this rap game is. Save it and hold that, you catch a hot one. Rhymes are chasing fate, get down soon as I spot one.
Clip. If you wanna mess with this, gangstar, one of the best yet. I'm nice like that. It's all good in this business of rap. Full clip. If you wanna mess with this, gangstar, one of the best yet. I'm nice like that. It's all good.
So I suggest you take a rest. So if you stand in my way, I'ma have to spray. Learn that if you come against me, son, you're gonna have to pray. Since back in the day, I held the weight and kept my head up. They wanna see the guard catch an L, it's all a setup. I give no man a thing power over me. Why do you feel so jealous and looking sour over me? I'm bold, G. I'm like impossible to stop. I'm like in the ring with you, impossible to drop. I'm like two magazines fully loaded to your one. Plus, I ain't gonna quit spitting till you're done. Plus, more than ever, I got my whole shit together. More than a decade of hits that'll live forever. Catch a rep of my name, you're bound to fly. Know how many niggas that I know that's down to die. We never fail, and we ain't never been frail. You niggas talk crime, but you scared of jail.
Full clip. If you wanna mess with this, gangstar, one of the best yet. I'm nice like that. It's all good in this business of rap. Full clip. If you wanna mess with this, gangstar. Thank you.
Yo. What's up? Welcome back to Sabir Bey Show. In the building, we got the teacher in the building. All day and night. Yo, we got the teacher, KRS One. What are you doing, man? Come on, man. We got Space Dweller in the building. That's my co-host, Tasha. Tasha. Woo. No, we're waiting for you. We was waiting for the teacher. Come on, man. You good? You good?
Okay, so we good. I'm here now. I'm here.
What's
I'm here.
Going on, everybody? Welcome back to Sabir Bey Show. We got the teacher.
Am I supposed to sign in?
Yeah, you want to sign in. You going to give you and you got that, too. See? See how this thing go down in real hip-hop?
Yeah.
See how it go?
You ready to take care of business.
We got to adjust the mics, man. He's trying to adjust his mics. See?
Don't even wait for me. I'm
telling y'all, see? Y'all can try to sit up here and try to... He said, which one is his? He's trying to adjust his mic, too. Go.
Yeah, I'm good now.
I love that track.
Okay, yeah.
The cheeks is back. The heat is back.
It's a Molly Mall track you got on.
I already know, bro. We was at SOB's when we did this, too, man.
It's interesting.
Yeah, but you want it. The heat is back.
Come up a little bit more, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, welcome, man. Wow, man. Welcome, Chris, man.
I'm happy to be here, finally.
Finally, to be here in the
finally,
studio.
Finally, you know, man. Chilling. This is a great thing you guys are doing here, man.
No, you're part of the family, man. You know, you're part of Temple Hip Hop, man, all day.
Wow.
So what's up, Chris, man? Like, man, finally got you in here, man. I've been many different places with Chris, man, and this spot here is home. It's funny that we linked up in L.A.
That's crazy.
That's crazy. From New York
with all
over
these
the
clocks behind you.
That's
wow.
Every city with a radio station.
That's
is at.
Right.
So we got people viral, man. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter.
Nice,
you
nice.
He looking around.
Nice.
He's still amazed. See, this is hip hop. We had to create
nice.
It.
No, this is nice, man. Come on. I mean, people can't. They can only hear us, so they can't.
No, they can see, us.
Oh, they can see us.
They
well.
Looking at you.
Yeah,
but,
oh, okay.
Cameras,
cameras
everywhere.
Hey, what's up, y'all?
Come on, man. This ain't no brother.
Down,
they looking at
down.
Us right now, man.
No, this reminds me of like college radio.
Wow.
You know,
wow.
Like the look of it.
Right.
It's like college radio.
Well, this is East
like,
Coast too. You know that, right?
Hot.
The owner right there. He's from East Coast.
Wow.
Philly. All day where I'm from. Mm-hmm.
Philly in the building.
Yeah. Well, you know, Philly and New York is neighbors, man. So we families. Come on, man.
Damn.
Yo, I want to, again, invite everybody again. Tell a friend. We got the teacher, KRS One, in the building. We was on the phone talking back and forth about some things. But we're going to do more talking here at this particular show. In between, we're going to play some music. But I wanted to, Chris, to see this movie that we were talking about, Django, which is a big thing. And, he didn't see it. He said,
got to back up off the mic.
Got to back up. No, because you see the stuff we got here, right? We got law dictionaries. We got civic. And actually, this is the book I was bringing in to show you. This is actually an older dictionary.
Yeah, that looks pretty.
You put that down. Book to use.
No,
nice.
I bought that book like that.
Really?
That book is... Trust me, that's like over $2,000.
Oh,
that
wow.
Book alone. Period. Beat up as it is,
wow.
It's one of the original law dictionaries, Bouvier's. That's better than everything somebody's carrying now. Black's Law, whatever.
Okay.
That is that book.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody in Congress, politicians, that's the book that they carry.
Wow.
You bet. Many different law books. Ballantyne's, Bouvier's, Blackstone's, the whole nine.
And so use that book was how much?
That book right there. Well, I only paid like probably 50 cents for that. But now if I wanted to sell it, I can sell it as it is.
Wow.
This is how crazy it is right now. For $2,000, if I choose to do that.
Yeah.
That's a gold mine. You know what I mean? I know Chris has the fourth edition, right? You got the fourth, right?
No. This is not.
I'm talking about yours.
No, I don't know if this is Black's Law.
That's not Black's. That's Bouvier's.
Right. No, I don't have this at all.
No, I know you ain't got that one. And a lot of people don't
right.
have that.
No,
that's why
I said
that's
this.
History right there.
I have the fourth edition of Black's Law Dictionary.
Explain to people what that is, because people probably say, what is that, a black dictionary?
Nah,
explain to people, man, because you got some ignorant people. Like
It's a basic law. It's actually a law dictionary. It's one of... the common law dictionaries. It's called Black's Law Dictionary. They come out with them every 2 or 3 years. There's probably an eighth edition out. But what's interesting is how the law changes every once in a while. Every time these books come out, little words change here, little things, little inflections, little things get switched around. And people don't realize how the law is really changing around them every day. every month, every year, definitions change. Mm-hmm. One thing that you may have thought was one way on Monday, mm-hmm. on Thursday, it's not like that anymore.
Exactly.
A good example of this is when we were growing up, we had nine planets when we were growing up. And as we grew up, we were told that one of the planets, I think Uranus or
Pluto.
Pluto was it, was no longer a planet. Wow. And now we had eight planets, and then that went for like a year. We had eight planets, and it was taught for like a year. A quick year went by, and then they said, okay, we don't have nine planets. We have eight. No, we don't. We have billions. So now we have a new telescope in the sky, and there's billions of planets out there. This concept of only nine planets in our solar system is no longer valid. Mm. Now, we've been growing up for years. People have been basing their lives, their reality, their spirituality on nine planets in the sky. And this is the importance of how knowledge changes. Laws change, reality changes, and if you don't change with it, you're stuck in a
stagnation.
And it's worse than stagnation. It's like you're really moving and having life in a reality that is no longer.
Mm.
Like most of us are still living Aristotle's reality. Like Aristotle's reality was there are seven levels to reality, and the highest was the seventh heaven, and we still attribute the number seven to spirituality and heaven and so on. And a lot of this comes from Aristotle, at least in terms of Western civilization's knowledge and so on. A lot of it comes from there. This idea that God is at the center of all perfection comes from Aristotle. You may believe that in your own self. You may think that, you know, it may be a conviction of your own.
Yeah.
But in terms of knowledge and education, this concept of God being the center and the highest and the greatest and the that's all Aristotle. That's not even the Bible. That's all just Aristotle. But then here comes Francis Bacon, who disproves Aristotle.
Who is Francis Bacon, man? Listen to me. You know, some people are new to this. They don't even know who these people are. Like,
well, you're online. You can just, while I'm talking, you can just type these people out.
There you go.
17th century philosopher Francis Bacon came out with something called the New Organon. As a matter of fact, Aristotle came out with what is called the Organon, and it was a way to argue points of view so that you can get at the truth. But Aristotle felt as though that the only real authority was God from the Bible, actually. Mm-hmm. Not God in the Bible, but God from as taught by the church was the ultimate authority. And we should get all argument is based on your proximity, your argument's proximity to God. And Francis Bacon came out and said, no, that's not how arguments are won. You have to actually analyze the subject in which you're talking about and so on and so on. So you're holding up a book
you called see that?
The Art of Deception. No, what are you pointing to? Update. Oh, thinking. Yep.
Critical
An Introduction
thinking.
To Critical Thinking. People throw that word around a lot.
Yeah.
Critical thinking. In, you know.
How to deal with arguments. This is one of the good books. This is a good book right here, man. And I share this with people a lot. But like you said, we threw this around a lot. Yeah, it's a hot book, ain't it? See, this is what we do on the show. It's like these types of books people need to know. Like you said, the law doesn't change itself. Mm-hmm. It's the policies that change.
Okay.
Law is universal. If I take... That's wrong. We know that's nature. It's wrong, period. I know that's wrong. If I injure you, it's wrong. Wow. That's nature. And nature is going to take its course. So the law doesn't change itself. It's the policies, the statutes, the ordinances. And people got to know all those things. And I'm going to say this, Chris, because in the movie, and I'm going to go to it real quick, because I said this. It's a good book. You pick that
up. Just ran through several philosophies. This one here, Persuade a Skeptic. That concept of skepticism, that's deep in philosophical debate and argument and so on. And it's been argued three different ways. Aristotle, René Descartes.
Yep. It's mentioned in there.
It's argued in so many ways. But which way is the way you gonna argue it? How, like, once you get past the symbols – It's funny you say the art of deception, because once you get past the symbols, you law is very easy to understand.
There you go. Thank
like,
you.
Like, very easy. These big, thick books and this, that, and the other, that's only there to hide the truth. But once you understand the basic principle of what's actually being done, and which is also scary.
Yeah.
I mean, to really look back and, I mean, to really look, man, you a slave, for real.
I mean, I'm not a slave. Like, I ain't no slave, man. I got a car outside, man. I can get up and leave when I feel like leaving.
Man, what? I'm on TV every day.
Yeah,
what
are you talking about? I can get in my car when I feel like it. I ain't no slave, man. Get out of here,
yeah,
man.
No,
talking
about
Chris,
don't
Chris is crazy. Yep, Chris is right. crazy.
That's
Seriously?
Right.
No. He's right.
No, that's it. No, I'm wrong. Because the society says, no, you're free. Society says, you're free. So you believe because that is the authority. That's who's pointing the gun at your head. So that's the authority, the one with the gun at the head. And this is the basis of reality and law itself. This is it right here. It's that we live in a militarized society. So reality, and get this. Now, this is the mind blower right here. Because what I'm saying is not wrong or bad. Damn, here you go.
I'm going to take over the show.
This is evil. This is evil, what I'm about to say, right? This is so evil. What I'm saying is not wrong or bad. The way government operates or the way the manipulation of reality is not wrong or bad. Here's the reality we live in. If everything was the truth,
mm-hmm.
you'd have no freedom. You couldn't do anything. You couldn't do nothing. You like breathing air is the truth. That is the law.
Yeah.
Stop, break that law and you're no longer in this dimension. Mm-hmm. Okay. To be in this dimension, gravity is a truth. Breathing air is a truth. Speaking and you comprehending is a truth. Now imagine if you could go outside of what other people believe truth is. They told you at gunpoint. Truth is this book, The Art of Deception, that these symbols, this T, this H, this E, this A, these symbols are saying the art of deception. But if you could look past these symbols and make these symbols respond according to your perception of them, you're free. If all we do is look at the symbols that these people offer to us, words, numbers, laws, this, that, and the other. And we start to look, we say reality is based on the symbol. Reality is based on this. Now, here's what I was getting to. If everything we do is real, okay, and is the truth, then we can't make nothing up. And this is why the American society is one of the greatest societies on earth. Here's why. Because it's all a lie. other societies right. live by truth. You steal something, we cut your hand off. You rape somebody, we raping you. You do truth. What you do to others, you getting it for yourself. Truth.
Wow.
America says no, truth is not here.
It's not here.
No truth is here. This is called deception. We're going to make up a reality that's not truth. No. It's based on truth. You can find it in all these books if you really want to know.
Mm.
But for everyday people, you're going to live in a matrix. You're going to live in a made-up illusion. And the reason for this is so that you can become more than what you truthfully are.
Wow.
In real life, you ain't nobody.
In the Matrix, you can be anything.
But in the Matrix, you can be anybody. You can do anything. And this is what makes America great. This is what makes this country great. When you understand the lie, it reveals the truth.
Ugh. Wow.
It's so evil. Understand the lie. The lie. See, most people are looking for the truth. You don't want the truth.
No, they really don't.
You don't want the truth. The truth is the lion eating the deer or the zebra or some alligator leaping out of the swamp and biting your leg off or eating your kid. Like, imagine your little kid, you walking through the woods and something just come and snatch him and eat him, run up in the tree and eat him.
Wow.
Like, that's the truth. Like, that's the truth. You don't want the truth.
No.
What you want is a nice street with concrete, no stray animals around. The pigeons are chosen for you. The bugs that you're pushing off are chosen to be there. The trees, the buildings, the color of the buildings, everything is set up. It is not real. It is a prop. Now, once you understand that, now you start to say in that prop, I'm whatever it is I want to be. I said, I'm hip hop. Me, in this made up fantasy, I'm going to be hip hop.
I'm going in deep, Chris.
That's what
I'm going in deep. I'm hip hop too, all
in
day.
In this made up thing, that's what I'm going to be. And this is what it's become. This is what it's become. Imagine the term hip hop is our term. We create reality with that. Like reality. Like imagine like.
It's not about a salary. It's all about reality.
Reality. What money do you need if you understand the reality that money is in? Money is not real in and of itself. We all know the story there. That the whole banking system is trust.
Well, most people don't know the real story, to tell you the truth. They're in the matrix.
We'll see. And this is the thing. And I'm not going to speak too much because on this subject because I'm also giving away the game, too. And every real seeker of truth knows that certain things you can't say publicly or you shouldn't say because you give up the game. You weaken the game. But in this particular instance, it's important to let people know at least one time, at least just once, okay? Let them know it's all an illusion. It's all made up. And if you understand that for real, you will make yourself whatever it is you want to be in this made up reality.
Yeah.
Don't seek the truth other than within yourself. Outside, there's no truth out here. You can forget it. This whole thing is time. Look at all these clocks. How could you have so many clocks on the wall if time is real?
It's an illusion.
It's an illusion. Boston's time is not Oakland's time. Oakland's time is not New York time. LA time is not Miami time. So what's time?
Let me real quick. This is what Noble Drolley said to y'all for all the Moors that don't understand. Noble Drolley said time never was when man was not. So time does not exist. I'm going to repeat that again. Happy. Actually, this is Noble Drolley's solar return for y'all that don't understand. It's his birthday today, January 8th. Oh. Actually, my mom passed on this same day.
Wow.
4 years ago, my mom transcended 4 years ago on this same day. So I actually was going to dedicate this show to my mom because on that day, she passed away 4 years ago and on Noble Drolley's birthday. And he said that time never was when man was not. So time doesn't exist. Time in is emotion. And people got to understand that. Like Chris said, all these clocks. How could you do that? I asked the same question. Seriously? You know, so this is what this show is really about. So we trying to bring the real information to people the right way and have edutainment. Fun as we do it.
Well, see, that's the ultimate form of knowledge is dance, poetry, rhythm.
We got poets in the building.
You know, this is the ultimate form of knowledge. Malcolm X put it this way. He had said that to make things, and I'm paraphrasing, to make things more complicated, like, matter of fact, I'll say what he said, actually. He said, the measure of intelligence is how you take something complicated and make it simple.
Yep. Yes, he did.
And, of course, the measure of ignorance is how you take something simple and make it too complicated to understand.
And you know what's funny? That's how attorneys do stuff. They make stuff complicated to people.
Right.
They make it complicated so you wouldn't, you know, I'm going to say overstand it for those that don't understand. I'm not under anything.
That's right.
I overstand everything. You see, language is important. Go ahead.
So question. Okay, so if time is not existing, we are tapping into a reality at the same time. So what is your theory on that? I mean, we all here. I mean, we can say this is just an illusion, but we are living this moment together. You know what I'm saying? We're looking at the same time. We're observing the same things. We can look at the news and see what's going on at that time. So we are existing as one. I mean, are we just, you know, coming in as like travelers and just meeting on this plane and having an experience?
That's
right
another
now?
2 hours right there.
You know what I mean?
That's another 2 hours right there. No, but I hear exactly what you're saying. And see, this also points, let me deal with that directly. understand that our very consciousness is what's we don't have anymore. Okay. It's not that we don't have, we can get it right now if we decide to live the original way we were meant to live. Mm-hmm. Here's an example. Here's with time, okay? Time is made up by people who have to control nature itself. Mm. The world is not the earth.
Mm-hmm.
The earth is an actual living being that we live on
right.
in the universe.
Right.
The world is what people do on that being. Time doesn't exist for the earth. Time only exists for the world.
Mm-hmm.
What people are doing. Now, we were original earth people. We were a part of the earth. The earth doesn't have time. The earth has seasons. Mm-hmm. There's no need for that. There's seasons. You flow in and out of.
So the controllers set up time?
Yes. Okay. Time is set up. For the control of nature.
So it's like we're playing a game. We're going against the controllers. And
Well, see, once you know the game, you don't want to go against it. Mm-hmm. Hey, let's lose all of these times.
Okay.
Matter of fact, the fact that you have all of these clocks on the wall actually means that you understand the fallacy of time.
Right.
The illusion of time. Right. Because you got all. Now, imagine a person that is only connected to Los Angeles time.
Mm-hmm.
That is their clock. They don't understand no mm-hmm. other time. That's the time. Their salaries are connected to that time. They're picking up their kids in school at this time.
Mm-hmm.
This is the clock I work on.
Right.
Now imagine the illusion that they're in.
Mm-hmm.
That their whole day is based on this machine.
Mm-hmm.
And just 6 hours away, say in Arizona, the machine's different.
Mm-hmm.
Closer to the mic.
I'm doing that on purpose.
Right.
I know you are. He don't understand.
I'm doing that on purpose.
We understand.
Because when you come close like this, that's when you're really making your point.
Exactly. I know that. I know that. He's telling you that. Well, real quick, y'all listening to the Sabir Bey Show on LA Talk Live. Y'all, yo, hit us up in the studio at 323-247-7443. I got my man KRS One in the building, the teacher.
We can get back to that.
He's going in. Go ahead, bro.
No, we'll just to put a period there, because that's a very important question. We are in time. We are in time.
Okay.
Because only because we're in society. Mm-hmm. We've chosen to live in this civilization. So if you choose to live in this civilization, then there's nothing wrong with this civilization's rules.
Right.
The only problem is when you believe these are the only rules
right.
that are,
right.
and you have no place else to go.
Mm.
You have no place else to think. You can't maneuver. When their rules fails,
mm-hmm.
you got nowhere else to go. Or when they're trying to impress their rules mm-hmm. upon you, you got nowhere else to go. That's where this mm-hmm. form of knowledge really comes in. It's not really even to go up against their rules, because the wisest minds on earth created these rules.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
The people, like, this is an ancient technique this is.
Mm-hmm.
Make the world believe that the good is a threat.
Wow.
And this is how the world is kept in control. If you really believed that the world was controlled by evil, manipulating people, there'd be riots in the street tonight.
Mm-hmm. You know what?
People Ooh. Would not stand for it.
Mm.
But you don't really believe that. What you believe is the people running this is just like me.
Mm-hmm.
They just like, you know, they may do a little dirt here and there, but they just like me, basically.
Yo, there was a scene in the last Batman like that, when a dude stood up on a truck. And he said that in the movie.
Yeah,
he said in the last Batman, the guy that had the mask on his face, he was saying that. With the illusion, yo, they was going crazy.
Damn, I got to see that.
You got to see some movies. You got to see Django, man.
Django I got to see for
you gotta, listen,
educational purposes.
You
Batman.
Said something, go back a little further, about the whole duress piece. In that movie, at the end of the movie, it was a scene in there with Leonardo DiCaprio and the guy who was buying Jamie Foxx's wife back.
Mm.
And they was dealing with bill of sales, contracts, all this was in the movie. He said, down south, we shake hands. Now, he already signed the paperwork.
Right.
He said, but down south, we shake hands. He said, well, if it's an option, I don't have to shake your hand. This is what the guy was saying who was with Jamie.
Right.
He said, this if it's an option, I don't have to shake your hand then.
Right.
Right? So he said, well, if the nigga leave out the door, talking about the girl,
right.
shoot her. Right. So they debating. So he walks over to the dude and shot him. He said, because down south, he shot Leonardo DiCaprio. He said, down south, we shake hands. People don't understand that when you say understand is a contract, the word understand is a contract.
Right.
In there, he said, it was a scene. He said, shake my hand. That's a contract. That's how I used to do it back then. Mm-hmm. A shake of a hand was a contract. So he was saying, I don't have to do that in the movie. Mm-hmm. So when he put the gun, had the gun facing the girl, that's a form of duress. People understand there's a term called duress, because now you're forcing me to go into a contract with you. Right. So now you're going to hold me liable later on.
Right.
And he knew this. Watch the movie at the end.
But that's kind of like the days of old. I mean, are you saying it's an energy contract now? Is that an energy contract? Like you giving that energy to somebody? Because, I mean, in the days of old, yeah, you can shake and agree. But now it's a new thing going on. We're dealing with energy. Well, you know, so.
Yeah, let me share this with you. Again, it is energy, but. People don't understand how easily you are led into contracts. What I'm saying to you, the modern day bounty hunters, which they were in the movies, were the cops today, the police. That's the modern day bounty hunters. It's the same game, but the players are different. See what I'm saying? You don't understand how they did it. But I love that piece with Leon, Quentin Tarantino was doing. And we got to call it real quick. You got something, Jerry?
Yeah, let me say this too. You know, I lived in Japan for 18 years, right? And in Japan, if you notice with most Asians, they bow. They don't touch. Don't shake hands. Right. It's always about, because that way there is no commitment.
Okay. See, we got some legends in the building. We got a call on the line real quick. Let's take this caller. Welcome to Sabir Bey Show.
Hello, hello, hello.
Yes, welcome to Sabir Bey. Peace, welcome to Sabir Bey Show.
Yes, I just wanted to say shout out to Tasha Auset and KRS One, and you also, Sabir. Thank you for the knowledge and the game. I'm from Philly, calling from Las Vegas, and I don't want to take up any time. I definitely want to hear the conversation, so just wanted to show some love to you guys and allow you to continue your process.
Thank you, sister.
Thank you. Thank you, sister.
Thank you. Yeah, but all this, you know, all these things that we're talking about, Chris, it's like in this particular movie, and and that's why I wanted you to see it.
I gotta go see it.
You gotta see it because.
They should give you a percentage of it.
I know. That's why I'm saying. Exactly. I wish they would. Make a phone call. Shoot. You know, give me a percentage of it. If it's something that's good, I'll push it. You know, even your stuff, man. It's like I always push this. Even when I was on doing radio back in Philly, and I'm not even going to give the station's name, but I used to kill the KRS ones. Right, you know what I mean? They was like, Sabir, I mean, I got to come to your show on Friday just to listen to Chris.
Right.
You know, so that's what I would do. You know what I mean? So. And I'm glad to have him in here because we would be catching each other at shows and different stuff like that. And I would sit down with him and we would build. But this is his home. This is the Zulu Nation's home. We're here. You know, I love this brother for giving us this platform. We're going to take a break real quick and we're going to come back with more KRS-One, the teachers in the building. Listen, call us up 323-247-7443. I'm going to get that by heart. I'm going to get that number by heart.
I'm over here looking at the wall, but we're going to get it.
I'm going to get it by heart.
Yeah.
Space Dweller in the building. We'll be right back. Sabir Bey Show.
Mother, mother, there's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Father, Father, we don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way to bring some love and get here today. Picket lines and picket signs. Don't punish me with brutality.
Thank you for tuning in to LA Talk Live, reality radio, and graphic for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live. And we're more than just talk. Stay tuned. Young Connection, your one-stop connection for all your graphic design and commercial printing needs. Young Connection is a full-service printing and media design company dedicated to providing the highest level of customer service and satisfaction.
Young Connection provides swift response and rapid turnaround services for banners, brochures, business cards, letterheads, church bulletins, funeral programs, flyers, logo design, posters, and much, much more, all at an affordable price. Young Connection, the official printing company of LA Talk Live. Give them a call at 310-491-3336. That's 310-491-3336, or visit their website at www.youngconnection.com. That's www.youngconnection.com. Young Connection Printing and Media Services, proud sponsors of LA Talk Live, where it's more than just talk. Are you ready to enjoy the Maui lifestyle? You can have it all by owning real estate on the Paradise Island of Maui. Dennis Rush, a 22-year Maui resident and real estate broker, brings his wealth of experience and market knowledge to add value to your Maui real estate understanding, providing a level of service as unique and exceptional as the island of Maui itself. The magical island of Maui was voted the most exclusive resort island in the world by Condé Nast Traveler, and keep in mind, Maui is only a simple non-stop flight away. Hawaii Business Magazine Top 100 Realtors awarded Dennis Rush the 2011 fourth top realtor on the island of Maui. Go to www.dennisrush.com to view all of the amazing properties currently available in the Maui MLS system. Whatever your needs or desires, Dennis Rush will provide a private consultation for any Maui properties your heart desires. You will be in good hands. Once again, go to www.dennisrush.com. That's www.dennisrush.com. Contact Dennis today to start your Maui lifestyle now. Dennis Rush, proud sponsors of the Dawn Christie Show and LA Talk Live.
Every year I get newer, I'm the duck. Every year I get newer, I'm the dust on the moon. Every year I get newer, I'm the dust on the moon. I'm the trash in the sewer. Let's go. Every year I get newer, I'm the dust on the moon. I'm the trash in the sewer. Let's go. I come back. Every year I get newer, I'm the dust on the moon. I'm the trash in the sewer. Let's go. I come back. Every year I get brighter. If you thinking hip hop is alive, hold up your lighter. Let's go. I come back. Every year I'm expanding, talking to developers about the city we planning. Come on. I come back. Through any endeavor, this is hip hop. We gon' last forever. Hip means to know, it's a form of intelligence. To be hip is to be update and relevant. Hop is a form of movement. You can't just observe a hop, you gotta hop up and do it. Hip hop and hop is more than music. Hip is the knowledge, hop is the movement. Hip and hop is intelligent movement or relevant movement. We selling the music, so write this down on your black books and journals. Hip hop culture is eternal. Run and tell all your friends an ancient civilization has been born again. It's a fact. I come back. Every year I'm the strongest. KRS, Molly, Mall, yeah, we last the longest. Let's go. I come back. Cause I'm not in the physical. I create myself, man. I live in the spiritual. I come back. Through the cycles of life. If you've been here once, you gon' be here twice. So I tell you. I come back. Cause you must learn too. Hip hop culture is eternal.
Come back every year, I get stronger. I'm what? The dust on the moon. I'm the trash in the sewer.
Huh.
I was gonna get Chris started, but yeah, yo, hey, boy, I'm hip hop too. Trust me, man.
Hey,
all day, every day. That track is sick right there, man. Come on, hip hop.
Big up the Molly Mall.
Big up the big up the Molly Mall, man. Africa Bambaataa, man. The whole True School,
right.
Grandmaster Flash, Cool Herc, True School. Welcome back to Sabir Bey Show. I'm in the studio with my man, the teacher, KRS One. Got my man, Jerry Bell, legendary Daz Band. You know, New Birth. Man, we got the squad. Space Dweller sitting over the Young Soldier. He's getting, you know, some history right here, right now.
Right now.
From hip hop R&B, and listen, man, look, we're gonna go. We got some announcers, right? Tasha, my co-host over here, Tasha, sitting in the building.
Yes, Dr. Jose Pimenta Bay is going to be at the Victory Banquet Room, okay? And this is going to be January 12th from 3 to 6. Tickets at the door, $20. No, $20?
Yeah, $25 at the door.
$25 at the door, but in advance, $20, okay? Call this number, and the number is 562-644-3194. Jose Pimenta, you do not want to miss this.
Listen, let me just real quick before we get back into this. This brother right here, Chris, I would love for you to come through there. Because
I'm looking at the date right now.
Yeah, because this brother is a professor. I believe it's up in Kentucky University. He's brother from Cuba. But he's going to tie in the whole history of the Latinos or the Mexicans and the Moors. This brother, if you don't know who this brother, look him up on YouTube. Jose Pimenta Bay and his brother had a book called Othello's Children in a New World. That's his book. It's been out for like 10 or 15 years. But Othello's Children in a New World, the brother's fire. He's going to give it, you know, go down on the 12th, man. Actually, we have brother Booker T. Coleman coming in March the 30th. Hiawatha Cabernet.
Yes.
Big up the brother Booker T at the KRS Unity Center. We got a lot of people coming in Philly, LA. Go ahead.
Yo, and on one of the shows, I want to be able to give the history of where the martial arts came from.
Oh, yeah. I forgot, Chris. Man. We got to talk about that one, too, the martial arts. So we could probably bring that up, too. So, like I said, a lot of stuff is going down at the Sabir Bey Show. Okay. Let's get back to the subject at hand. We got a caller? Yeah. Let's take this caller real quick, Chris. We got a call on the line. Welcome to the Sabir Bey Show.
Yo, yo. What's good?
What's good?
Your boy, Urban Voodoo. What's happening with y'all, man? How y'all doing?
Oh, it's all love.
Hey, Urban.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, man. All I can say is, first of all, it's an honor to even be able to call the Sabir Bey Show, to be able to say what's up to Sabir Bey and Tasha Auset,
right.
But to be able to big up Chris, the teacher.
Yes, sir.
Who got me into hip-hop in the first place. Definitely big up KRS-One, man. Appreciate the subject matter, man. And I love how y'all talking about time and how time is something that's a figment of the imagination. We are timeless, man. And the masses need to know that.
Yes. Yeah, man. This is what the show is about, brother. We bringing it, man. We got a lot of heavy hitters coming on, man. A lot of stuff is going to be built.
You up. Actually got listeners.
Oh, stop playing. Stop playing. You going to go back and listen to this, huh?
Wow, yeah. Dudes are responding. Like,
listen,
you
going to have... Listen, Bambada's listening, too. He just don't call in no show. So, you know, so he don't call in. So, you know... Hey, trust me, we got listeners, man. Believe me. You know, you'd be surprised who's listening on this show, man. You know.
Most definitely. I also want to tell you, man, to hear about the birthday of the prophet, Noble Drew Ali, on radio, man, for people to know, because they don't even talk about Noble Drew Ali in school.
Yeah.
Man, Islam, Mo Peace. That's some dope stuff, man.
Yes, give thanks, man. And you know what's funny? It's a documentary I did on Noble Drew Ali called The Prophet of the People. And Mos Def is in there, Bambada's in there, C. Freeman Ells, and everybody's in the piece. You know, and it's the first time it's ever been done on Noble Drew Ali. It's because nobody knows about him in history. He's before the Nation of Islam, before all of these people.
Yeah.
You know, and no one talks about Noble Drew Ali. Yeah. But you're going to now.
Right.
Well, like the prophet says, it's the time for the great meeting of Asia.
That's
That's
right.
You know, people are coming together. And we just got to stop being falling for the illusion, man. They put these dudes with their pants hanging to their ankles on TV like, that's hip-hop. And it's like, dude, that ain't the hip-hop I knew. Hip-hop made me want to read something. You know, the whole verse for you must learn. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But you know, my philosophy, you know what I mean? I don't know nothing that Lil Wayne talking about. I'm sorry.
Well, Chris probably going to talk about that a little bit, too. But you know what's funny? Chris said, and I don't know if he remembered this a while ago, he said, the one who condemns is the one who loses. I don't know if you remember saying this, because I remember. He said, instead of condemning the guys with the pants down, just create a pair of pants with underwear connected. See how I remember? Now, I'm going to tell you when this went down. I'm going to tell you when this went down. This was over 2 years ago he said this. I remember when he said this. And I believe we were in Philly, I believe he said this. See what I'm saying? So, again, this is what hip-hop, we're about here to teach. And this is what we do at the Temple Hip-Hop.
Right.
Teach. Not teachers. Right. Not teachers.
Right.
Teach us.
Right. And
thanks, brother.
Each one teach one all the time. We're here to not only learn, but to also teach what we are learning. And, you know, we got to bring it back to where, you know, the rappers were poets, you know what I mean? And they wrote from a point of view of consciousness and thought.
Thank you,
and,
brother.
You know, they'll follow us. You know, we give them that white style. They're going to change us and get right, you know.
Thank you a lot, brother. Thank you for calling the Sabir Bey Show, brother. Stay tuned, man.
Peace out, bro.
Yes, sir.
Peace, KRS One.
Peace to you. You know what also, and what the brother I think is alluding to also has a lot to do with self-responsibility. Like, you know, not everybody can stand up for their people or actually speak truth to power or just speak truth, period. Mm-hmm. People can't really do that. That's not an everyday, you know, it's not something that everybody can do. Mm-hmm. The real issue is if you can do it and you don't.
Right.
Those who do have knowledge that don't speak, mm-hmm. Those who have some sort of experience, some sort of wisdom that don't impart that, don't write a book or do a DVD or, you know, something like that. I mean, I would hope that this conversation inspires them.
Yeah.
Finish that book if you're listening to it. Right. Finish that, the edit of that DVD. Finish that album.
Right. Right.
You know, whatever
you need to read the gospel of hip-hop. That's what they need to read.
Well, come on, man.
They need to read the gospel of hip-hop.
They're getting it right now. They're getting it right now.
Seriously, be the book. Ain't that what you say?
This right here, Jose Pimenta.
Pimenta Bay.
Pimenta Bay, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Pimenta Bay. This is, I just wanted to go back on this real quick because when I looked at his presentation here, the origins and history of the Moors.
Mm-hmm.
What was real interesting was I was watching Beowulf the other day.
Wow.
And I was watching it because at first I was reading Beowulf because I was doing some studies on English, just the English language itself. And Beowulf is one of the early English, probably the first English poetry written. The first English epic is Beowulf, written in English, like handwritten kind of deal. One of their first manuscripts in English is Beowulf. So one of the first lines of Beowulf, and I can't even say it because it's old English. I haven't even studied it yet. But it alludes to the fact of this monster called Grendel. Grendel, basically, is this tall monster that live amongst the moors.
Wow.
A dark-skinned monster that lives amongst the moors. And this is Beowulf. And Beowulf's legend is how he slays the monster and the monster's mother. And they steal this goblet, this horn that they drink wine from. They stole it from the northern Moors, the chiefs of the northern Moors.
You're going deep,
This
dude.
Is all in the Beowulf movie.
Wow.
Now, I'm not an agent for Beowulf movie at all. Maybe I should get my percentage together.
You need to.
What struck me is when you showed me this, I just was thinking of just a few days ago, I was just watching Beowulf, and I was shocked at just the inflection of what the Beowulf story is about is Beowulf killing Grendel, who lived amongst the Moors. And I was just thinking, and of course my study goes in how most of early Africans coming from out of really not even humans, like hominin humans, prehistoric Neanderthals, or others, Homo erectus, Australopithecus, these people coming out of Africa, the biggest conspiracy really is the death of their history.
Yes.
Is that, that because, and it's all misconstrued because, like, you know, Africans don't want to talk about early Africans being cannibals. You know,
what you talking about, Chris?
The early gods. They say the early gods were 12 feet tall and ate humans. And this is like known throughout much ancient history, but we try to cover that part up.
That's not what y'all was talking about in Hidden Colors too.
No, that's right. See, wow. That's what it did come out.
Wow, you can tell he like, you know,
I didn't get
that?
My coffee. I didn't. Hey. No, but that's exactly right.
Okay. Yeah.
And of course, the sister's referring to.
I know. I was in the first one.
The Hidden Colors, right.
I was in the first one.
I'm trying to think of the director's name. I can't get
it. You know what? Thank you guys for that. Bringing information to the people. You know what I'm saying? People was like, wow, you know. Now we truly know you are a true teacher.
Oh my God.
What I'm saying? Especially
I've
in
been
part two.
A teacher, yeah.
Me and my friends, you know, after we watch Hidden Colors 1 and 2, we always sit back and converse on things. And my friend was like, you know, at the end, KRS-One, he asked that question, whatever happened to the robes? You know what I'm saying? And we were speculating. We was like, you know, I was like, you know what? They probably took those patches and put them in their suits. And when they go into their private meetings, they just flash, you know. You know, what's up? You know what I mean? You know, but that, you went in deep on that
we
one.
We talking about Masonic-wise?
Oh, yeah, Masonic-wise. You know.
True, man. Picture that. But you another thing that they don't want like to talk about, Chris, is of us holding slaves, neither. You know, that's another thing that most people of us don't realize, that the first ones were European slaves. A lot of people don't even know that. That's where the word slave Slavic come from.
Yeah.
It was the Indo-Europeans and Scandinavians. That was them that was the first slaves. So again, this is where the whole masonry thing comes in.
Okay.
Because we sent them up in the Caucasus Mountains. Mm-hmm. And it's where you get the term Caucasian from. Mm-hmm. See, there's a whole lot of history behind it, but we must address, and this is why I'll go back to Django. He was talking about stuff that they're not talking about in the movies. Mm-hmm. Like, you would see a Western, but you ain't talking about the, you know, what was going on with our people at that particular time. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So they only focusing on the nigger part.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Instead of focusing on all the other elements that was in that film.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? What he was doing, how he's going to find his wife, and the laws, the contracts, the bill of sales. And I'm like, y'all just focusing on that?
Mm-hmm.
Come on, get over it.
Right.
Let's talk about what we did. That's why I like this movie, because I haven't seen nobody do a movie like that.
Big up to Jamie Foxx.
Yeah,
big up to Jamie Foxx, man, because for him to take that, you know, and out of ignorance, people say things and they don't know. Mm-hmm. They don't know half the stuff that they're talking about, you know.
Yeah, but a lot of times these our people get to positions of power and don't do films like this. I mean, just what you was just speaking about. I mean, come on, Oprah couldn't do this? I mean, Color Purple, that's it?
You know why. Come on, stop it. You know why. Come on.
That's it.
I mean, come on, Chris. This is
when are we going to see a movie that goes, like, beyond the pyramids? I want to see what happened before then. When are they going to bring some heat like that? You know what I'm saying?
You know what? Be honest with you. According to the evidence, it was boring. Before Egypt. They say the Sumerians were just in peace.
Oh, okay.
Like, what you would see is just a bunch of us sitting around eating all day.
Oh,
for real?
Just seriously, like walking down to the river, coming
back. It's like some of the drum sessions they have. I hear this goes to the drum sessions.
So they won't talk about us creating other people
That doesn't sell.
See, fantasy sells.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Now we're back to what we opened up with. Right.
It's not about a salary. It's all about
reality.
If you tell the truth, it ain't selling. It's not what people want to hear, and it's not even, it doesn't motivate society when you really think about it. Now, think about it. That is so crazy what I'm saying.
Yeah.
They speak the truth, and suddenly people are depowered.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine that. You speak truth, and people suddenly feel depowered.
But you know what? Our people don't even want to hear the truth.
Well,
let's do this real quick. We got some young brothers in the room. let's go to Space Dweller. What do you think about this stuff today?
Right.
Let's go and hear from the young ones in here, because they don't want us. We got to pass the torch to, and that's the one of the problems that we don't do, is to pass the torch down to the younger ones.
What are you thinking?
Like about the music today?
The music, everything. What Chris was just talking about. The whole, now I know you travel with Chris, you know the routine, you're going to get this because this is the teacher. You ain't going to get no better than that.
Yeah,
that's
no
like, and I'm going to say this, because a brother told me, sitting with Chris or Bambada is like sitting with Barry Gordy. You're sitting with Barry Gordy right now, I'm telling
Barry
you.
Gordy.
Exactly. I remember being at dinners at different hotels, and every time we eat, it would just be giving me knowledge all day.
He's passing the torch down. So it's like people say, well, they don't want to hear this, you know, and it's like I'm looking at you. You know, Chris is passing this down to you and saying, look, now you take it and you do it your way. And you educate them on what is real music, what is really going on.
Exactly. And what I'm trying to do is...
You're not trying, you are.
Well,
What I am doing
is trying to bring this, or am bringing this knowledge to the new generation by, you know, trying to kind of make music that has the newer sound to it, but that still has the message behind it. Which is, you know, I try to preach, you know, the unified field theory, which is, you know, the theory of oneness, that everything is one, and knowledge itself, and, you know, just different, you know, just different aspects of knowledge. You know?
That sound like Chris, man. God darn, younger Chris. That's crazy right there, man. Hey, you was looking up something in this book. What was you looking up? You were speaking on something in this law dictionary.
And, you know, I'm taking advantage of just the knowledge that's in front of me. What I'm looking at is police, the definition of police in these books.
What is that?
Because it changes. It changes. This is one of the first things that have changed. Like almost every year, the role of the police change. And it's funny, you started out with, you know, they started out as bounty hunters, as slave catchers.
Don't they come with papers and say?
Oh, no, no doubt. Come on, you already know what that's about. And you know, these hired thugs basically to protect the rich. I'm just listening to that. I mean, I'm looking at that. That's why these books are out. Unrelated to what we're speaking about here, let me come back to Space Dweller.
Space Dweller in the building.
What's real interesting about Space Dweller, two things that should be looked at is the amount of family support that you get.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
That's the real. I want to shout moms out real quick. I just want to shout.
First and foremost.
I want to shout moms out real quick. Yeah. Because she actually, imagine, you know, this is, you have a mother. I'm talking to you. Let me talk to you.
Yeah.
You actually have a mom that believes in you.
Yes, and that's rare. And
come on, you know that's rare. That's rare. I didn't grow up with that. A lot of MCs coming up didn't grow up with that. We had to fight our parents to be this, to do that. You know, where our music was noise and don't touch the turntable, that kind of thing. And although, you know, parents, they care about their kids. I'm quite sure. I mean, you and your mom have a mother and son relationship.
Yeah, you don't even know. Moms used to MC back in the day, too. You
know? I did know that, actually. I actually did know that. But, you know, this type of support, I bring that out because this is crucial to anybody making it anywhere. You know, this is crucial. This is what you don't normally get. And one of the things I saw looking, I mean, I call you Space Dweller, Trey, that we're looking at he came on board because of my son, actually. My son and himself hooked up. It was just, you know, both trying to get their career started, doing their thing.
He's a bad DJ too, then.
And he's trying to do his thing. I'm super critical dad. So the thing is that they came together. And it was Chris that actually wanted him to go out like that. Me, I could care, like, whatever. Yeah, you know. But got out there, and what it was the heart, which is so important. If you don't have courage, you ain't going nowhere. You ain't getting nothing. You could be a brainiac. You could have talent. You could have inheritance. You could have God on your side. If you don't have no courage, you're going nowhere.
Yeah.
And it took an awful lot of courage for you to do what you did. We didn't just go from here to Arizona, you know what I'm saying? Like from here to, you know, San Francisco. Mm-hmm. We went from here to Germany, wow. You know, from here to England, from here to, you know, like we was in the sea. We was out in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. We're, you know, we're out there, and the normal person or normal people have cracked. You know, they have cracked. 30, 40-year-olds had to be let off the boat. They couldn't do it. Say, oh, you can believe on tour. I mean, like, look, standing here like this, we all talking. I'm going to go on tour. Okay, it's a 100-day tour. We're going to go from here to Canada to this place to that place, and we coming back. I'm ready. I'm down. I can do it. We get out there first date. Anything can happen. You go in front of people. Okay, there's 1,000 people looking. That 1,000 people. The person right here standing next to you. Wow. Yeah, I got you, my dog. Get out there, 1,000 people.
Freeze up.
They can't think. Rhymes gone. They can't function. They don't even show up. Some don't even show up.
Yeah.
Stuck at the hotel. I don't even want to come out the room.
Right.
I'm so good. You be like, well, you was the dude. You was lyrical dude on the corner. What happened? And what was good, though, was that Trey came out there and was legitimately consistent through each time. Every time he got a chance to rock, because a lot of times I would say, no, just watch me.
Right.
Stand there, watch, look, see how the crowd rocks, see what beats we throw on, see what it is. But then when he got his chance to go on, he was actually able to talk to the crowd. And this is a different thing, too. I got to point this out because this MC's listening to us. Trey was in places that didn't speak English. So there was another level of MCing we had to get to. It's not English. It's not your words that these people want. It's your character. You got to get out there and act like you the man. You the one. And, of course, he had no problem doing that. I'm quite sure his mother might have, you know, somebody over here, you know, somebody, you know. So, yeah.
You got to think, none of them knew who I was, or I was up on stage, you know, by myself. Like, no when he doubt. Would pass me the mic, he would go out into the crowd and sign autographs and stuff. So I would be up there by myself. And wow. even though he was in the crowd, I would still have the attention of most of the crowd who wasn't trying to get autographs.
No doubt.
Which was really a good feeling for me because, wow. you know, they, none of them knew who really who
he
I was.
He had to fight. He had to fight for respect. Yeah. He had to fight for respect and won the respect. I think your greatest show was the last one at Jazz Cafe in London.
Oh yeah.
That was, I mean, you came alive right there. You know, these were, and I mention all of this to say, I mean, just because MCs are listening
is
well. These are the other parts of stardom and success that you don't normally get to hear about. A mother that cares about her son, sending him off overseas to try to do something. He gets out there, these experiences, he has no idea where he is, nothing, but has to pull it off every night, and also there was a little bit of a hustle out there, because you know how I get down. When we land in a certain place, we got to come with a hustle. Mm. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
We coming up on our break, man. We got to take a quick break real quick. You listen to
the B-boy break.
Yeah, I'm going to get down to breakdance.
That's right. That's that hot right there.
Chris, you did say hip-hop connects us to humanity.
No exactly. doubt.
Sabir Bey Show, we'll be right back after this message.
To LA Talk Live and the Talk Live Broadcast Network, for original reality radio and crafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk. Stay tuned. Young Connection, your one-stop connection for all your graphic design and commercial printing needs. Young Connection is a full-service printing and media design company dedicated to providing the highest level of customer service and satisfaction. Young Connection provides swift response and rapid turnaround services for banners, brochures, business cards, letterheads, church bulletins, funeral programs, flyers, logo design, posters, and much, much more, all at an affordable price. Young Connection, the official printing company of LA Talk Live. Give them a call at 310-491-3336. That's 310-491-3336, or visit their website at www.youngconnection.com. That's www.youngconnection.com. Young Connection Printing and Media Services, proud sponsors of LA Talk Live, where it's more than just talk.
Oh, your skin looks great.
Thank you.
What's your secret?
Frankincense and myrrh oil by Ancient Essence.
Frankincense and myrrh oil by Ancient Essence?
Yes, it's a beauty secret used since the time of the Greeks and Romans. The spa in Malibu told me about frankincense and myrrh by Ancient Essence, and now my skin is lovely.
Well, your skin looks great.
Call Ancient Essence at 1-800-627-9813. Discover the secret of beautiful skin. Call 1-800-627-9813. Discover the secret. Frankincense and myrrh oil by Ancient Essence. Discover the secret of beautiful skin. Available at fine spas and beauty centers.
Yo, 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 welcome back to Sabir Bey Show. Yo, y'all also can check us out on Facebook. Check us out on Facebook. Get at us, and if you want to advertise, sponsor, yo, get at us at the station. Listen, this is the only place you're going to get this information. The Fifth Element of Hip Hop. Sabir Bey Show. Mm-hmm. And don't forget, next Saturday, y'all got to come out, meet and greet Jose Pimenta Bey the 12th. He's coming to L.A. Yes, y'all don't want to miss that, man.
Yeah, I may be there, though. For real talk.
I know you.
I might have to be there because his talk on the Moors, like I said before.
Oh, man.
I'm
going to
be there.
That's going to be bananas, Chris.
I need to see that.
It's going to be bananas, man. Welcome back. We got a great... Going back to the teacher, man, we got some current stuff that we're going to build on because we were talking about some stuff we need to do. And we're going to talk about the temple of hip-hop. What's going on with that, Chris?
First of all, you're showing me these books, but I can't borrow them, right?
Let me think.
You know, the bind of the books thing.
I do not lend out books. So I'm a total hypocrite for even asking.
It's like gold, man. I had books that I didn't even get back yet.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I tell people to invest. I always tell people invest in yourself. Buy these books.
Yeah.
Get them.
Yeah.
I have a couple other books. We got the King Alfred's Plan. You know, I got etymology books. We got these books you can buy.
Right.
You know me,
right.
but those type of books. These are cheaper than those, though.
Yeah.
We ain't giving those out, so they ain't happening.
Sabir, you know, one of the things that we need to talk topic on is are people reading?
Come on.
Because a lot of our people don't read, man.
You
know
what I mean? What you talking about? I do read, man. What's them books called? Them fantasy books? We read? What are you talking about?
They read online. And that's what a new reading is. You touched on something so deep right there about reading. You know, and being able to read different things. I mean, read graffiti, read hieroglyphics or hieroglyphs.
Yeah.
Read.
Can you read? Speak different languages. I speak seven.
He speaks seven languages.
Wow. Parlez-vous français?
Whatever, man. I speak one.
Oui.
I speak Blinglish. Blinglish. Whatever this thing is called. Whatever it's called, man. Blinglish. I don't know. You know? Hey, let's go back to Chris, man. What's going on? Man? You say we got some current stuff going on, man?
Well, yeah, of course. You know, I thought I saw your face at the Winter Solstice event we had, the gathering on December 21st.
Yeah, I was there.
Right. I saw you moseying around there in the back.
Yeah, man. You know, I'm always in the cut somewhere.
This is where we start. We had a phenomenal start. As you know, December 21st, 2012 was the end of the Hopi calendar, the Egyptian calendar, the Mayan calendar. A lot of astronomers have predicted that this was the real beginning of the age of Aquarius. We've now entered a new age now with the winter solstice this last time, all the planets lined up, blah, 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 the movie 2012.
Right.
What we did was announce for hip hop the birth of a new ministry. No other ministries have been birthed to our knowledge. We scombed the internet, we looked around, we called. Nobody really announced a new spiritual path for the new millennium. No one has done this. We wanted to unite with other people who may have had spiritual paths because, remember, these cycles of time are, well, the ones that we're following is 2,600 years, 2,600-year cycle within a 26,000-year cycle. And these cycles of time actually bring with them, with the completion of each cycle, brings with it new ideas, new religions, new nations are even born. So we figured this out and looked at hip hop and said, wow, take a look at this. 2012, here we are alive, able, like, you know, this is the blessed age. This is the age that everybody said, you know, we supposed to have floating cars and, you know, this is it. This is the age. All of that. This is the age of Aquarius. This is, I think, the fifth dimension had a song on this. This was that blessed age. This is it. So what we did was we announced a new ministry there. Actually, same ministry, the Temple of Hip Hop. But we announced it as a new ministry, meaning that our press campaign went out new. But the Temple of Hip Hop basically is a hip hop preservation society. It's a ministry because we believe that the only way to preserve hip hop, not the only way, one of the sure ways to preserve hip hop is to preserve the hip hopper. For us to become hip hop, not just do it or collect it, but to become it and then preserve ourselves. If we can preserve ourselves as a culture, hip hop in its essence will be preserved because hip hop is not an object, it's a subject. And most people, when they talk about the preservation of hip hop, they approach it as an object, something to be bought or sold, traded, a book, a thing, you know, an object. When in fact, hip hop never even enters the physical world. It never. It's not of this dimension. Hip hop. It's not. You can't go to it. You can't wear it. You can't drink it. It's not here. It's not in the three dimensions that we live in plus time. It's somewhere else. And that's what led us to look at, well, where is this somewhere else that hip hop is? Where is it? How do we all know it psychically? We all know it. People in other countries who don't even speak English still know hip-hop.
Exactly.
In essence, what is this thing that we are all engaged in? And this kind of a think tank, this kind of trying to figure out the essence of hip-hop is what is called the temple of hip-hop.
There you go.
Now, you can go a little further with that.
Let's take this caller real quick before we go.
Yes.
They dropped it? Okay, they call back. Call back to the studio. Go ahead. Continue, Chris.
It goes a little deeper. Those that are part of the Temple of Hip Hop, because the Temple of Hip Hop basically is anywhere you are. If you say you are hip hop, then
here we go.
Between your two, between your temples, you know, I'm pointing to my head right now. Okay, you can see me, right? Okay. you know, they call this part of your head the temple.
Right.
Uh-huh. Your temple. This is where the temple of hip hop actually is. It's in your head. It's right there. It could even be in your heart if you take it that further. But we do believe that if God is omnipresent and omnipotent and everywhere, then hip hop is not outside of God. So then what is the purpose of hip hop from a spiritual point of view? Why is God thinking us up? What is the point? What is why hip hop? What is this? Mm-hmm. And this then leads you down to really realize that, wait a minute, you mean to tell me I can know God through hip hop?
Yeah.
I can actually know the universe. I can know the mind of the universe through breaking, MCing, graffiti, a DJ. And the Temple of Hip Hop is here to say, oh yeah, you can. And as a matter of fact, that was the first way we met God, was through breaking or through dance, speech, body art, body movement, cave art, rock art. The four core elements of hip hop, breaking, MCing, graffiti, or DJing, are also the core four elements to human existence. It's not just entertainment. Breaking, MCing, graffiti art, cutting, mixing, and scratching. These are things that hominin humans did. These are things the first humans did to say they
were
human. Where
did the scratching come in back then?
That's fire. That's clothing.
Oh,
that's right. That's all that cutting, mixing, scratching. That all of that. That's the. In fact, graffiti is an Italian word meaning scratch.
Graffiti is also the modernized hieroglyphics.
No doubt.
Yo, you know what's funny? I said if I ever go back to court, let me tell you. I said if I ever go back to court, I'm taking the gospel hip hop in the courtroom with me.
Okay.
You know how they get you? You know how they say that you swear on the Bible? I said no. The Book of Revelation says don't swear. I'm gonna swear on hip hop because I am hip hop.
Right.
You know they said, what are you talking about? Chris trying to make a religion out of hip hop? Mm-hmm. It is, because if you watch basketball, football, anything, you watch it religiously. So for critics. And this is for all the critics that's out there, because I hear a lot, but it's, you be around Chris, you see this. Well, Chris trying to make a religion. It is a religion. Reline yourself back to hip hop. That's what I would say.
Right.
Reline yourself back to real hip hop.
Right.
And what other religion should you have?
Hey.
This is the point. I mean, imagine in the times that we're living right now, like the times that we're living, 2013, okay? Uh-huh. Our Abrahams and Moseses and Jesuses, they're still walking around.
Exactly.
Like, imagine this. Like, I mean, take it back to Christianity in its first century. You know, so Jesus just died on that cross, just defeated death, just went into the right hand of God in a cloud and pillar of fire. Jesus is gone. Full victory. Now here comes Paul. So Paul never met Jesus, nothing, okay? Paul gets some revelation from a horse that's talking to him. Now, Paul then says, wait a minute, this Jesus guy, this Christianity, this I myself was not a disciple, but I believe on this dude right now, and here's what we need to do.
Yeah.
We need to set up churches in these places, and I'm sending y'all letters and trying to tell y'all how to do this and this, that, and the other.
Mm-hmm.
Now, at almost every religion on earth begins just like this.
Yeah.
And they always begin at the beginning of a new age as well, just like we at right here. The issue is, why do we not believe in ourselves? Why do we not believe in ourselves to this level? It's like, for me, I tell people all the time, I'm not really interested in hip-hop being a religion. I'm more mm-hmm. interested in its culture, its exactly. Nash being a nation mm-hmm. in that sense. But your religion is your culture. Your culture is your religion. You don't separate the two. You don't have one culture but praise another god. But this is what we're doing. We have one culture, like, say, called African-American.
Whatever that is.
Whatever that is. But let's just say we have a culture called African-American, Afro-American. Mm-hmm. Whatever. We have a black culture, let's mm-hmm. say. Where's the god of that black culture? The god of that black culture, which may be a black woman or a cat or a monkey or a bear. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, really, like, black people, we all get together and say, listen, we believe that the bear is the ultimate symbol of God. And you kill bears, we killing you. Mm-hmm. Let's go. So now we got beef with the NRA. We got beef with this one and that one. So on, because our religious symbol is the bear, and you killing the bear, and this is the problem right here. Right. Now, why would that be? Why is that even important? Because as silly as it may sound, as silly as it may look, your whole nation is standing on something that another nation knows you're willing to die for.
In India, they do the same thing. I think the cow is sacred in India.
The cow is sacred. Yeah. No, but they still getting bucked down, though. Big yeah. up to my Hindus out there, which mm-hmm. y'all already know what it is.
The cow and the cobra.
You know, the cow, right. But the cow. No, but the cow is what it really is. So here's our breaking music, and just to put
because I know you got a great go, but yeah, you come back. I don't want to, you know.
Well, I'm definitely coming back for these books. You didn't say whether I could borrow them or not.
We're going to talk about that. Which one you want, man?
Go this ahead, one.
Nah, that's not mine right there, though. Oh. That's actually, you got to talk to the sister out there in the hallway, Karen, because this is her book right there. She will try to cut you, boy.
I don't have this.
You know what? But I'll, as a matter of fact, I'll get you the bun. I'll get you one.
I don't have this.
Okay, you can talk to her. She's in the hallway.
It's very rare to bring a book to me that I don't have.
You got this?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Okay. You got the contract book?
I got
book?
this, and King Alfred. I don't have this.
Contract book.
And I don't have this.
We'll make sure you get it, though, bruh. We're going to get it. You can talk to the sister in the hallway. We can be right back. The teachers in the building's great role. Yo, a round of applause, y'all, everybody. Listen.
Big up to you, first of all, and congratulations on this show, man. You are doing it way big.
Thank you, man.
Way big. Yeah,
thank you, man.
Everybody out there listening, send this brother some money right now. Send him money right now. If you enjoyed this conversation, support him. That's my point.
Yeah, we need our own village.
No doubt.
Big up to Africa Bambaataa, man. Chris, thank you, man. Peace. I'll see you next time. The doors are always open.
That, man.
All right, peace and love.
Peace and
love.
Be
back.
Thank you. people, it's Jennifer Tapier from StarCam. You guys might know me from the red carpet, catching up with all the stars, but guess what? We're bringing the red carpet to the radio right out here on LA Talk Live. I'm going live Thursday nights at 6 p.m. We got hot topics, celebrities, and much more. We were featured on Chloe Lamar on E!, Howard Stern, T.I.'s Family Hustle. You know how we do. So check it out on Thursday nights, 6 p.m. All things Hollywood, everything celebrity. StarCam Radio.
StarCam Radio.
StarCam Radio.
Oh yeah, follow us on Twitter at StarCam Radio.
Hey, what's up? It's your girl, Forbidden Gem, inviting you to join us every Tuesday night at 9 p.m. sharp for the hottest, livest talk show, Forbidden Tuesdays.
Join us as we expose the new generation of love and dating and help y'all run the game right. Ladies, beware. Fellas, bring out your notepads.
So don't forget to tune in to
Forbidden Tuesdays
exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV. This is
LA Talk Live,
and we are more than just talk.
You ready?
Hi everyone, Chef Richard Petty here to tell you about LA Talk Live's new cookie show, Let's Do Lunch, with me, your host, Chef Richard Petty. Let's Do Lunch launches Saturday, January 19th at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Well, tune in to Let's Do Lunch with me, Chef Richard Petty, Saturdays, 10 to 11 a.m., exclusively on LA Talk Live. We're more than just talk.
That's what I call it here. Ho, ho, we on the air, y'all.
Uh-oh.
Come on, y'all.
Sabir Bey, hold on, man. I'm sorry. I know that's your show, dude, but hold on. You just had my favorite artist on your show, dude. My favorite artist of all time, and I got to give big ups to the Sabir Bey show for that.
Thanks, man. D-Brax, man. Wednesdays, man. He be going down on D-Brax. And actually, this is the first brother show I was on in California when I got here, the D-Brax show. You know what I mean? That was hot. So he's in the building, the Rap Project.
Big up to DJ Haze, though.
DJ Haze in the building. Welcome back to Sabir. Yo, this track is so sick that Nas said everybody's looking for a hero. Mm. He said, hate it or love it. That's how I feel sometimes. You got some that hate me, some that love me, whatever. If you hate me, get out of my way. You know what I mean? I'm going to rip your team apart. That's what he says. Wow. I'm going to rip you apart. You can hate me all you want. That's, it comes with this business, man. You know, so you get negative and positive. And only the positive, the people fear what they don't understand. Like Nas said, hate what they can't understand.
Yeah.
So this track is sick. That's what made me come back to radio. Seriously, what I can and can't say, I'm gonna say what I want to say. I'm only on the Sabir Bey show, man. Big up to my man Rich is in the building for actually pushing me to come back to radio. Told me I couldn't go nowhere. You know what I mean? So I got to give props to my man. We got space
man,
dwelling
to
the
you,
building.
Man. Don't step off from that too fast. Can we get a round of applause for this young brother here?
Yeah, yeah.
Second week back in radio, bringing mad heat to the studios of LA Talk Live and the Talk Live Broadcast Networks. Big love to you, man.
Thank you.
Boy,
thank you.
We're going to do major things together this year.
Yes,
I guarantee you, man.
Yes, sir, man.
And big ups to my main man, KRS One.
Yeah.
The one and only, the inimitable KRS One. The science was so deep. Man, it made my head spin, dude. I had to. But when he come, I said, I'm gonna wait my turn, because when he come back, I'm going to challenge y'all on that topic of freedom.
Free and dumb.
If this ain't free, I don't know what freedom is, brother.
Free and dumb.
Are we free here now?
I'm free.
You're
all
free
day.
To
I'm
say
hip-hop.
Whatever you like. I'm going to leave it up to you.
That's
great
right.
Show today. Another round of applause, please.
Thank you. Thank you. We got the legendary Jerry Bell in here, for those that don't know. Daz Band. Yeah. You know, New Birth. And if y'all like to support the sponsor, you better get at us now, because, you know, rates going to be up mad crazy. You know, so you better get at us right now. Contact me or contact the station. Also, hit me up on Facebook, Sabir Bey. Twitter, The Sabir Bey Show. And listen, it's going down every Tuesday, 3 to 5. Yeah. Hopefully, we get another day. You get the sponsors. We need the sponsors. So, hey, let's go
you
back.
You could do this more than once a week?
Oh, yeah, man. I could do this all day. You know how I say Michael get on stage and get comfortable? That's how I get behind the mic. Yeah.
Oh, well, then you just need to start planning another day then, brother, because if you're bringing it like this,
hey,
bro,
I know, man. It's crazy word. Because it was like somebody said you need more than one day, and I'm like, well, wait a minute. I'm just trying to wrap my brain around trying to do one day, besides the lectures and the events that we got going on, because also I'll be at the Shades of Africa in Long Beach this Thursday speaking on language.
Word.
You know, and that's very important that we understand what language is, like jurisdiction. Juris means law, diction means speak. You know, so I'm versed in law and I have good diction. So come on, jurisdiction. So we got to, these are the things we're going to bring to the table too. So like, isn't this a dictionary? Say law, dictionary, diction, speaking. What did Malcolm say? No good diction, right? All right, know the dictionary, know the language.
All right.
So we're going to be doing that this Thursday at Shades of Africa. So come out if you're there. It's going to be
Give
fun.
Give them the
man.
Details, please.
Yeah, it's going to be Shades of Africa in Long Beach. I don't like giving really plugs to certain places unless they're advertising or sponsoring. So, but I will be in the place. All right?
Somewhere in Long Beach.
Somewhere in Long Beach.
Where
on
in the
Facebook.
World is severe,
right? Yeah. So we had a fun day, man. There's a lot of stuff that was going on. We got a poet. You got a piece? I mean, you got a piece for
you
us?
You want a piece?
Yeah, we got to get a piece, man, for those that don't know who Tasha is.
Yeah, and you know what? I'm going to tell you about Chicago. Tell me. Because I am from Chicago. I'm Chicago native.
We got Chi-Town in the building.
Yeah, for sure. Man.
Big up to my man, Mel Jackson. He's actually the producer, one of the producers of the show. Mel Jackson is the famous actor from Soul Food, the light-skinned brother that y'all like, with the pretty lips that everybody keeps saying.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the producer.
He's a Chicago native also,
yes, he
right?
Yes, yeah. Oh, wow. And he will be in the building coming up soon, too. Okay. So we got
well, since y'all plugging Chicago, Cats, let's plug Calvin McDowell of Calvin Cold Cuts with Calvin. Yeah, let's plug him, too. Well, a gentleman, we call this one of the silent co-founders of LA Talk
wow,
Live. Chi-Town brother, too.
Can I say one thing?
Sure.
If you're plugging cities, let's plug Philly. We got Jerry Bell. In the house. What the
hey, Philly, Cody Anderson.
Atlanta Talk Live's in the house. D. Bryce.
Hey, listen, we really need a lot of support for Wesley Snipes. Wesley's trying to get an early release from the place that they have him in Pennsylvania, and you know, we definitely need to. You know, to keep
behind that brother. Yeah,
yeah
man.
Yeah.
Well, it starts here today. How about that?
That's
We're going to start the campaign here today.
That's my message.
Free Wesley Snipes. Free Nino Brown. Free Nino Brown.
Girl, you got my piece. You got a piece for us?
Here you go. Here you go. Sweet Home Chicago, don't die tonight. Back in the day, everything was all right. Chilling at the lakefront, 31st Street, when we was booming in the Jeep. Garrett's Popcorn, Italian Fiesta, Chi-Town downtown, it can't get no better. Memories of sweet iced tea from Mason Jaws when little kids yelled out, no cars, no cops, and that's my car. Times have changed. Things gotten ugly. Can't go back dressed all fly. Somebody might try to mug me. Come on. Y'all know how them thugs be before they found their inner God. Yet and still, some of the hardest niggas on the block fear a white God. My sweet home Chicago, what's going on? I turned to the news the other day and it said another one was gone. Murder increasing. They acting like it's 1986, the movie Colors. The only difference is it's brother versus brother now. Could this be the media pumping it up because it's election time? The boys that graduated from urban preparatory school are doing just fine. These scales are unbalanced. It boggles my mind. Last stop all off. 95th Dan Ryan. Guys flashy, selling dope like it's the latest fashion. Why girls popping they thang for a transaction? Shots ring out like, oh, say, can you see? No, you can't. When you laid up in a coffin, surrounded by 6 to 8 men, that's how it is very often. I often drift into my own soliloquy of fake spirit to be or not to be, that is the question. I'm all grown up now, rest in peace to Ruby Hudson, she won't be stressing. Sweet home Chicago, don't die tonight, my mafioso city, blueprinted just right. Could this be the mafia plan? Taking a political stand? Cause this reminds me of the Mi-Alpha covering the Chicago land. Blood splatter from brain matter influenced politician over spaghetti dinners with linen tablecloths all white. A hot topic for fine dining at night. Rest in peace to Mayor Harold Washington, who was pulled away from the light. Can these shooters read or write? Are they skinny jeans too tight? Cause they didn't see that little girl who was riding her bike that night. When bullets went into flight, it was so obvious they didn't know their left from right. Sweet home Chicago, please don't die tonight. I'm so sick of people talking about unity is dead when we should unite like Voltron or a la arm, leg, leg, arm, and head. Sometime we must step back from the rack city chick, rack, rack city chick, hood rats, and get back to being black, learning facts, and straight up knowing how to act. Nevertheless, each time I roam, Chicago is calling me back home. Chicago is calling me back home. Sweet Chicago, please don't die tonight. Thank you.
Wow.
Wow.
Really? Let me tell you. Let me tell you something. That's the type of poetry that need to be on radio, and that's where you're going to find it on the Sabir Bey Show. Listen, I was talking to
And who's
to
that again?
Actually, the sister?
What's her name again?
Tasha Auset. Auset.
There we go. I'll just wait.
And we have another sister that has a book. She's in the studio, Asia Marie Jackson, yeah, man. It's hot. Called The Rose Storm Purpose, man. Yeah. The book, if you don't have the book, let me put it out there for everybody to see this, man.
How?
Yeah, some people spit it, some people write it.
Yeah.
All right, yes. I spit it, I don't write it.
Right.
She writes it. So we got to give a shout out to that. And you said some things about Chi-Town. I was speaking with a sister there the other day, and we was talking about how crazy Chi-Town is,
yeah,
you know, and the killing, even in Philadelphia. Actually, I got a phone call from, you know, and they said, no, Sabir, you got to talk about the news in Philadelphia because you don't talk about what's going on in Philly. It's bananas in Philly. A brother got shot Christmas Eve, and y'all can see this on YouTube. It's so crazy. They put on World Star. And I tell people, never slip. Anybody from Philly know you don't slip when you do something to somebody. Yeah, you rich know. You don't slip because they will catch you later.
Oh, wow.
He'll tell you. They will catch you 2 to 3 years later. I'm watching this clip as the guy robbed somebody's house and the boy went to jail. So-called paid his dues, and Christmas Eve he was dropping his daughter off and the mother off at a Walgreens in South Philly, and you can watch the film as he was following the brother parks the car, the children and the girl got out the car with the baby, the five-year-old. The guy pulls up directly behind him. You can see this on film. That's how stupid dudes are. They got cameras everywhere. See the dude get out the car. You literally see him shooting this dude like 6 times in a parking lot. It's not crazy.
For but a burglary that
for
took
something
place
that happened. Listen,
years prior.
They are killing cats in Philly over cell phones, man. This is how crazy. It's not like
That's
it used to
here.
Be. It's not like it. And people think out here is bad. No. Grow up in Philly. If you made it out, I was shot 5 times. I went through the whole 9. I went through the gang, the drugs, all that. The whole 9. To make it out of there, this brother called me the other day and said, he said, I'm glad you left. You made it. Because most people don't make it out of Philly. He can Jerry can bear witness what I'm
Let me
saying.
Tell you something. I left Philly in the 70s.
And it was worse back then. Junior Black. I mean, you had the Black Mafia back then.
JBM.
Not JBM. JBM was my era.
Right. But, that's true, though. You're
so
right.
JBM, it was a, you know, it was an offshoot of the Black. Yeah, that was the offshoot of those types of guys.
Sam
know.
Christian.
Exactly. Yeah. So when people see that movie,
tone those names, it might get us in some trouble.
The moon. No, not the really. We gotta, it is what it is. But we saw, they was our elders, you know. So when you see the movie State Property, that was real, but those dudes didn't live that life. You know what I mean? Wow. We lived that life, but they never came in South Philly. Junior Black Mafia was a clique, and it was really deep. You know what I mean? So when you see all these movies about State Property, Get Down the Lake, that was real. They never came to South Philly with it.
Well, Carpenter Street.
Exactly.
Y'all had it on lock. South Street had it on lock.
We had it locked down.
There was no infiltrating.
Exactly.
Even the Italian mob that was based out of some of those same neighborhoods, you know, couldn't infiltrate. Yeah, which y'all had on lock.
Yeah, exactly. And a lot of people don't understand, like, even it's what I'm doing, I know it's bad, man. But it's like, I look at things and people don't know, like, my history as far as how that was. I said, I've been through a lot in Philly, but I say, look, you know, I'm against gun control, but control your gun. Yeah. You know what I mean? The stuff that's going on now, man, it's like really ridiculous, man. Yeah. Cats 16, 17, 18 year old dying, haven't even lived life.
But you know what we are not seeing is the plot.
Phew, talk about it.
The plot, the plan.
Maybe we're not speaking on it, Jerry.
And that too.
Well, we'll hear it. I know you see it.
And the youth do not see what they're being, how they're being led into the slaughter. It's a setup. What the governments are planning, or the powers that be are planning, is that they have to annihilate a certain amount of people off the planet.
Yes.
So one of the things is to cause the friction between either race or between the same color, which are the youth, because they can get to them right now. They're not thinkers like we used to.
You got one right here in the studio.
Yeah.
Space dweller. Right,
so, you know, you know, when we were coming up, if we got into a confrontation with each other, we ain't like
one
another.
We were fist users.
We said, what was the word we used?
Give me a fair one.
Give me a fair one.
Give me a fair one. That's a Philly thing, y'all.
Hold up. And if you didn't really, didn't want to hurt the guy, you might ask, give me a fair one, to the body or to the head.
Yeah, that's what it was.
You might go to the body.
Exactly, with the body or the head. Which one you want?
You go to high school with dude. Yeah, you see him in your, you know, third period class of science.
That's right.
And y'all kind of homies. That's so you right. Like, or slap to the head, that's or right. Just go all out.
Exactly.
Give me a fair one.
And that's how it was.
And so what has happened is that they decided that this is how they set up everything. Okay, now, you know, we don't make AK-47 assault rifles. We don't make bullets. We don't make hand grenades. We don't make MAC-10s. These are a military, actually, weapons. So how does it get into the hands of the youth?
Right down there on Vine Street, Colosimo's.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, he went back.
Yeah, but check it out.
That's how they did.
No, check it out.
All the straw purchases he got going on.
This is what they do. They drive the, they'll park the, they'll have the trains to dislocate, the freight trains dislocate in the hood, leave the doors unlocked, and there they have all the ammunition. They'll bring the trucks in and park the trucks, jump out of the truck, leave it in the hood, leave the ammunition, leave the weapons. So, of course, you know, we are men of, you know, we're with our culture, we like to find out what's what.
We used to get the Coca-Cola truck. You leave that joint open, you know what I'm saying? And the ice cream truck.
Right. Jeez. You sit there, sit long enough, you know, the kids in the hood are going to say, hey, man, let's go check
Inquiring
this out.
Inquiring minds want to know.
And so this is where they find all of this stuff. Now you got it on the streets. Now it's in the hands of ones that have no idea of what they are doing. Now it's, I'm powerful. So now what they do is they use it against each other. Let me get an argument with you. What?
Bop.
And then that's what starts it.
Exactly.
Then what happens from there is you got the police that dress up like the Crips. You got the police that dress up like the Bloods. Now we're going to ride through the neighborhood. They don't know who's who. Bam,
right.
Bam, 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 bam.
Right.
Then all of a sudden there's a war. We're going to ride through the Hispanic area. Bam, mm-hmm. bam, 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 bam. Mm-hmm. Now there's a war. And they set us up for our own demise.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And we do not pay attention to it. And we so, especially the young ones, mm-hmm. they're so eager to I'm gonna get back, and they go out and then they kill innocent people, and then they kill people that have nothing to do with nothing.
A friend of mine's and actually we went up out of time, because we have another show that's coming up. We're gonna continue this, but a friend of mine I grew up with, his daughter just recently got shot in her head, and I was shot in my head, so I already know what it feels like. Yeah, it may not look like I got a bullet in my head, but I have one in my head, in my chest also. And I felt him. You know, he said his daughter got shot in his head and she had two surgeries. I didn't have no surgeries. But it was launched, he said, between her eyes and the middle of her head. It was from the back. And I'm like, wow, this is crazy. Then he told me 2 months after that, his son got shot. You know, his son got shot from the back. And I'm like, he said, remember you first cut his hair? I'm like, wow.
And this is all from our wonderful city.
A Philadelphia.
City of brotherly shove, as I like to call it.
Yeah. Yo, let me. We got a great wrap up, man, because we have another show coming in. Like I said, we're going to have to do another week. But I want to read this real quick, the King Alfred's plan offer, right, everybody, for that's not familiar with it. And I will be speaking about it at the Shades of Africa this Thursday. This is done in 1969. It's called Exec 84.
Executive Order.
11490 from 1969. It says, listen to this. Media, keep the adult public attention diverted away from the real social issues. Captivate them by matters of no real importance. That's the media. Schools, keep the keep the young public ignorant of real mathematics, real economics, and real law and real history. They doing that, right?
Right.
Entertainment, keep the public entertained below a sixth grade level. Football, basketball, and all the other stuff. Yeah, that's dumb. Work, it says keep the public busy with no time to think back on the farm with the real animals. All the King Alfred's plan, 69. So everything is full effect, y'all. It's there. I want to say peace. Thank y'all, man. We got to sign out.
Peace.
Sabir Bey Show. Check us out. Facebook. D-Brax. Wednesday. When your show, brother?
7 to 9. Wednesdays. The Rap Project. Check me out.
Yes, you may always see me there. I want to thank everybody. I want to thank DJ Haze. My DJ over there jamming.
To DJ Haze.
Karen is in the green room. Yeah. Jerry Bell. KRS One, the teacher. We got Prince in here filming. Yo, y'all get at us, man. The show is gonna be bananas. Next week, Big Red, Five Heartbeats, Hawthorne James will be in the building next week. Stay tuned. We got a lot of people coming in. Peace.
Peace. Love.
Reality radio and crafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we're more than just talk. Stay tuned.